Hello, I'm Rory O'Connor and I'm joined here by Catherine McGrath. How are you?
Good, I'm excited. Just played British Summertime.
How was that performing to 50 to 60,000 people?
It was so much fun. It was really, really hot as well. So it was a bit intense, but no, it was so fun. People were singing along. There were some new people who came up to me after and said, "We just heard you for the first time, love your music." So yeah, it was really, really good. Brought in some new people and saw some old faces, so.
Now you've had a bit of a whirlwind year. I mean, you're now on the bill with Michael Bublé and Van Morrison and the Shires. That must be amazing.
Yeah, it's so much fun. I actually got to tour with the Shires last year, so it's really cool that we're back at the same festival. But yeah, no, it's crazy. I love festivals because you just get to perform with people who are like a million miles away from the music that you make, and you all get to sing in the same place. So it's really, really exciting. Everyone's in a good mood. And yeah, it's fun.
Now you've got some tracks out, but your debut album has yet to be released. Now what can you tease a bit more about that?
So the album is out on the 27th of July, super close now. It's basically songs that I've written over the past 2.5 years right up until now. I wrote on them with lots of co-writers, songwriters that I've loved for years. And yeah, it's a 13 track album. There's going to be some songs that I've already released brought back, but some brand new ones as well. Songs about love and heartbreak and country music and everything. So yeah, I hope people are going to like it.
And how did you decide on how to team up with certain people, songwriters that you love so much?
Well, originally I was kind of writing with anyone that I could and just figuring out what worked and what songs we got. And then I kind of figured out who my favourite songwriters were, like Steve Robson, Jimmy Robbins. And so, I don't know, the more people that I connected with, I kind of went back in the room with them and kept writing. So I think I've got like 5 songs on the album with Steve Robson. He's amazing. But yeah, I mean, I did a lot of it in Nashville as well, which was really
fun. I was just about to ask about that. How was your time in Nashville?
I love it. I've been 7 times now. It's my second favourite place in the world. First favourite being home. But no, it's amazing. Like, the songwriters are incredible. There's music in every bar. The food's amazing. I love everything about it. So I'm really glad I got to make the album there in like the home of country music. So.
Now, obviously, country music is huge in Ireland. So what is the difference when you head over to Nashville?
I think like it's a different kind of scene. I think the country music in Ireland is very like folky and it's a different kind of vibe, whereas in Nashville, like, I suppose it's similar in that people play music in all the pubs and there's that community spirit. But for me, Nashville is where all the artists that I was listening to growing up were, like Taylor Swift and Rascal Flatts, Brad Paisley. So that was just really exciting for me to get to go into that world and be like, this is where they wrote their albums and they walked this street and this is where they started out. And so that was like a really overwhelming thing for me. And I don't know, it's just a really cool place to write an album, not only because of all the talent, but good weather, good vibes. I just love it.
So, just a nice holiday.
Yeah, it is. 7 holidays in Nashville.
Now, Talk of the Town has been a huge hit as well. How has it been for you to hear all the feedback from fans?
It's so nice, especially because that song started because somebody said something negative about me. So
it must be nice now to play that.
Yeah, exactly. It's like,
look how much has happened since.
Yeah, and it's like a good message, I think, for everyone. It's like, don't worry about what people say about you. Just go after what you want because it could happen. And like, so for that to be the song that people sing back to me at my shows and that people connect with is really, really good for me. I think it's a nice message to have as my debut album title as well. So yeah, super happy about that.
And with the debut album, you're doing some signings, aren't you?
Yeah.
Tell me a bit about that.
I'm going to be going around different HMVs. We're going to Belfast, London, Glasgow and Manchester. And we're just going to sign copies of the album. We're going to sing a few songs acoustically for people. And I don't know, I just think it'll be a cool chance to like meet people face to face who are getting the album. And then, yeah, we're going to go back out on tour in September after that and play some more shows, but that time with full band and a lot more songs. So it's going to be loads of traveling around. It's going to be fun.
And you're popping over to Australia?
Yeah, my first time going. I'm so excited. So I'll be supporting Morgan Evans, who's a country singer. He's from Australia, but he lives in Nashville. And yeah, I love his music and I've never been to Australia. So I'm going to find some koalas to hug and some kangaroos. And it's going to be an adventure. So yeah.
Well, if you've got skin colour like mine, you need the factor 50 plus over there.
Definitely. I'll bring like factor 100.
And what can fans expect next year? Are you working on more music? I know your album hasn't even come out, but you're always writing. Keep going for the next one, or are you going to focus on launching this one at the moment?
Well, I'm always writing. Like, that's something that I'll always be doing. So I don't know, the songs I write could go onto a second album. It kind of depends on what happens with this album. And I try not to get like too ahead of myself. I just focus on like the good things that are happening now. So for me, I'm just focusing on this album and the tour, but who knows where the songs that I'm writing could lead. We'll see how it goes.
Well, thank you so much for stopping backstage and speaking to me. It was lovely to meet you, and congratulations on your performance today.
Thanks, it was fun. Hopefully I'll come back next year.
Thank you so much. Lovely to meet you.